I go and everything you say, I'm already knowing, cause I ain't
against the rules. Everything you're going through, I've been living for.
Hello, I'm coming from the storage, getting my stuff ready for Christmas. I have been going through all my craft things and getting all everything organized. I have organized my storage to label all Christmas, all Christmas stuff, all Valentine stuff, all kind of different things, and I got everything pretty much labeled and down. So today and yesterday, started yesterday, but I started taking out all my Christmas stuff, getting everything ready, seeing what I have, seeing what I don't have, so I can start getting ready. The video today is about getting ready for Christmas early, so that by the time you know Christmas gets here, you're not like overwhelmed and at the last minute, I gotta get this, I forgot to get that. So my thing is, I say, let me make a video right quick to give some type of just a little hint on getting prep, getting everybody, getting the household prep for I'm sorry, I'm reading text. Getting prepped for Christmas, okay? So, one of my things is, I'm like, get the kids, get everybody, just the kids, but get everybody out the way early. Know who you want to get things for ahead of time, so that all you have to do is be like, okay, kind of start looking around and seeing what they want. So by the time Christmas gets here, they're not thinking about, oh, well, she asked me, I'm getting that or not. So just ask them, you know, get little hints of, oh, what type of things are you wanting or anything. So also make sure if their birthday is in between, kind of get little, you know, you can get like, I guess, one of the items for their birthday and then whatever for their Christmas stuff. So you can start, my point is, you can start early and start getting the stuff. So from July all the way up into like November, you can be prepping, like getting everything ready, getting, like, you don't have to just spend thousands of dollars. You can save, you can look at, you know, look for sales. Like, we're having a Busy Mom Gift Shops is having a Christmas in July sale. So it's like, okay, take advantage of those type of deals, because they have the they got that, and they got a lot of people doing Christmas in July. I was like, oh, let me do a Christmas in July. The last couple of years I've been seeing that. I'm like, let me just do a Christmas in July. That way, instead of me texting people and asking people like November, October-ish, like I did this year, which I made a decent amount of money with it, but that's fine. But at the same time, I help people, but at the same time, I'm like, okay, let me take another step ahead and just do it in July, like, you know, what I was checking out from the years previous. So now I'm like, okay, let's do Christmas in July, meaning you're prepping for Christmas in July, but you getting sales. So if you have anybody that's, you see having sales, check out the sales, check out how much they would normally be at normal times, and get those sale items, because you're gonna end up at the last minute trying to get all that stuff, and you're gonna overspend just because you're doing it at the last minute. Oh, I got bills, I got this. Cool, we got a plan for that. Get it early enough and little bit at a time, to the point where it's not even looking like you spent whatever amount of money. And the thing is, you will still be saving money and you won't feel like you spend a lot of money. Okay, so if you do the Christmas in July, say you do that, then you go get your coupons, you get your coupon, like the people that's couponers, get your coupons ready, start prepping now. Also, I don't want to miss out that people are doing back to school stuff. So in the middle of your back to school stuff, get your coupons for that too. Start prepping and looking around for stuff your kids like now, and your husband and your wives like now. Like, oh, they'll like that, they'll like this. So just start looking now. So if they have some deals in July, try to get it before the end of July. Prep for July. Get it by July. Or you can order it in July and, you know, tell a person, just have it to me by August or whatever. You can have it or whatever you want to do it. But please try to be where you're prepping, and you kind of starting to look into the things and getting some of the stuff. So around November, December, you chilling. You like, I'm finished. Like last year, I started early, but I didn't start this early. So I'm starting earlier this year. Last year, I was finished every single thing I needed to get by the Black Friday thing, because I'm like, okay, I got to put everything in lip, the big things that everybody wanted. My husband wanted a new pro PlayStation 4, so I put that in lip, where I put everything, all the big items in Louis' house, painting down. I was also looking at what's on sale, let me see. So I ended up, you know, normally if you a gamer or your kids are gamers, you know games are like $60-something, $70 per game. I literally got games, brand new games out the pack, $15, $20, $27, because I put some of the stuff I actually brought early while they first came out, and then when I caught the sale, I'm like, hey, can I exchange that? So I was just switching out stuff too also, so I was doing that too, but I was getting everything they needed as the time went by, so I can make sure I had the things they asked for. But at the same time, when I catch a sale, because I kept looking every time I go in there to pay on my little way, bam, pay on, I was like, okay, what's on sale this week. So every week I was like, yeah, bam, just hitting it up. And I was working extra at my job, my husband's working, so we was just working and just getting the stuff down. So by the time Black Friday came, we was like, it was like more sales. I was like, yes. So I was already pretty much finished, but then they let me, I was like, hey dog, can I please take advantage of these sales? Okay, so they let me exchange majority of my stuff, and I got the sale price, and I kept all the receipts together in the bag when I got the stuff. So I switched everything out, and that could have easily been like $2,000-$3,000 worth of stuff. I spent way less than that. I don't remember exactly how much, but it was way less than that. And that's items that I knew they wanted. My husband wanted, my kids. I got all this stuff in one place. Clothes. I always get them an outfit or two. Night clothes, slippers, like stuff like that. Night clothes. Every Christmas or sometime their birthdays, I'll get everybody either outfits, shoes, socks, stuff like that, stuff they need, because it can use it every day throughout the year. So I get stuff like that. I don't get like toys, and I don't buy a lot of toys anymore, because I find that my kids will, I don't know about other people's kids, but I know I find that my kids, people buy them stuff, or I buy them stuff, and then they be like, they'll play with it, it's broken all over the place by the next day or the same day, and you end up throwing it away. So it's a waste of money to me. I feel like, you know, don't waste money. Try your best to buy what the person needs or what makes sense for your money, so you wouldn't be spending all your money. And then when you know, it's like an investment. Like, because this year is going to be like, okay, what did they need from, what they didn't get last year, what they didn't get for their birthdays. So this year is like, oh, I just need my chair. I need my gamer chair. Oh, I need this. That's just one item. He had all of the games. He was like, I just need my gamer chair in one game. So I'm like, okay, because I brought like over 30 games last year, but I didn't spend that kind of money though. So it didn't seem like I did it, but I did investment, because this year all he wants now is the gamer chair, my son. So I'm like, okay, let me start looking for the gamer chairs now. So I'm gonna be looking, checking for prices, checking to see how much it costs, and see how much it go up and down throughout the time, and start, you know, paying for it and getting it, whatever I need to do with that. I asked, literally went around the house, I asked everybody, hey, what you want, so I can start prepping early, so that when it's time to start getting stuff, I see the price. Oh, cool, that's on sale. That was usually $100. It's $49. Let me get that today. And then if I see it again, but I keep the receipt. If you see it again, oh, let me switch it. You can switch. Some stores let you switch it out and get the better price. So just keep in mind, you can do that also. Like I said, do not forget to coupon. And I mean just different stores have different coupons. Sometimes Walmart have, but sometimes they have a Hanes coupon. You can get t-shirts, underwear, all that stuff with that. You can go to Dollar General. They have coupons in there. You can use that. They have a $5 on every Saturday or every other Saturday coupons. You can use that for like just random stuff, candles, like different stuff you want. You can go there. This was just like a little few tips for getting prepped for Christmas, because I feel like people waste a lot of money trying to do it at the last minute, thinking like, oh, I gotta do it. No, you're wasting money that way, because you're like rushing, and a lot of times you end up paying the full price of everything. Like you you end up charging your credit card, overdoing that, then you owing people. By the time Christmas, you depressed because you owe your whole credit card is maxed out, or you owe people because you borrowing money. You don't even have to do that. Do a little bit at a time. Especially if it's little kids. If it's little kids, get them little kids stuff. Don't be getting all that extra over-the-top stuff for no one-year-old, no two-year-old. They don't need all. Get stuff they need. Get their chair. Get their bed. Get stuff they need so that you won't be stressed the next month, because you're still going to need the chair. You're still going to need the bed. You're still going to need stuff. So if you're doing it throughout the months and out the weeks, starting in like June, July, you catching sales, you already ahead of the game. You already got the stuff at the house. You feel me? And you're not stressed, and you tackle two things at one, because you got them something for either Christmas or birthday, and you got it on sale, and you got it early, and you're not stressed and pressed about, oh crap, I spent all my money. Oh, now you got to borrow money for bills. Now you're stuck with that. So just that was just a little tip for Christmas prep. Like I said, take advantage of all sales. They have a lot of sales that's going out. My baskets are boxes are normally $35, $40, depending on what's in it, the boxes I have. And I'm doing those for like $20, $20, $25, depending on what's in them. So, I mean, if you take advantage of it or not, that's on you. But like I said, the whole point is to save and to be prepared. And if you get it early enough, you ain't even... You got everything ready. In some cases, you're going to have everything ready before November because you started so early. And you ain't got that much to get because the year before, you didn't got all the stuff you need to get. Birthdays, you didn't got it in between for the birthday. So you didn't pretty much got everything you need. All you need to get, look, night clothes, t-shirts, pajamas, you know, that kind of stuff for Christmas. You set because you didn't already got everything you needed. You saved, you got sales, and you good. So that was just a tip. I might do another one on some other tips, but right now, that's all I have for today. See you next time. Have a great day.